22, BNP gives 22 tickets to members of the Jamaat-e-Islami, which is a banned party at the moment, apparently because it's fundamentalist.
Yeah. No, I mean, one is the formal answer would be there is no BNP, there is no Jamaat, so how can they be Jamaat members? They are former Jamaat members. Now, the government or the legislature has not made a law saying a former Jamaat member will be disqualified from elections. Also, in choosing these people, we and the other parties in the coalition did not have a say. I have already expressed my thing that I'm unhappy that this was done, but they're not legally disqualified. Now, you cannot make an issue about why not people who are not legally disqualified are not given nominations. So this is something that you can ask BNP people. I'm sure that they will have some reasonable answer. But it's 22 out of 300.
It's not a huge significant amount.
I don't feel that they can, you know, in any way, even if they get elected, influence all the rest.
Please don't tell me you're an astrologer. But what would you say the results are likely to be?
If it's free and fair, we in the opposition should get a majority, a comfortable majority.
What if it is not and you don't?
Then next we will sit down and say why against all the indications that we are getting from people, and you will get those indications if you try and test public opinion here or even somewhere outside Dhaka. And also the number of arrests, that the figures that we gave. I mean, if a party which is in power feels that they're comfortable with the elections a week away, they don't arrest 4,000 people. They don't start hundreds of prosecutions and cases. This is not the actions of a confident government. This is the actions of an extremely nervous government, which feels the ground is slipping away from under them. And therefore, through repression and putting people in jail, they want to create an environment in which they think they might be able to get some result in their favor. So if there is a result in their favor, I will definitely say that you will have to see how these arrests, how these the repression of the preceding days of the election was all intended to create a situation in which they could get a result, which they can then say, we now have the result. And I would not at all be surprised if that kind of intimidation will be unfortunately visible in different parts of the country.